All right, I do not have a lot of time today, so let's jump right into it. That movie is a shit show. What you think you see, what you think you hear, that's what it's about. It's all theater of the mind. No, it's garbage. It's garbage. Mood and atmosphere. Now that I really like. That's what I'm looking for. That's what I want to see. Hey folks, how you doing? Dave McRae here. Okay, yes, like I said, I don't have a lot of time, so let's get right down to the nitty-gritty. Number one, this could be perceived as a spoiler. So if you do not want to know anything about anything that could possibly give you insight into anything, or something, I should say, do not watch the rest of this video.
But Dave, I need to watch your videos, man. I've got to watch them, man.
That's great. You've just been warned. The second thing is we have some video, some behind the scenes video from that flashback that they are reportedly shooting on the set of Halloween Kills. This time we have some video, and it basically shows Lonnie Elam running into frame, who we perceive to be Lonnie Elam, we're pretty sure it is, running into frame, looking around, and then Michael Myers comes into frame, stops, turns to his right, and heads in the direction of where Lonnie went. And everybody is losing their mind, saying, oh my god, it looks like a chase scene. I think it's a little premature. I mean, obviously, I think he's taken an interest in Lonnie, and he is certainly going in that direction. Whether it is an actual chase scene, per se, I don't really know. But we're going to look at the video together. We're going to go over it together. Now, I don't know where this video comes from. There's a watermark right across the center of the screen. It's a shameless plug at the Spook House podcast, I think it is. So if you guys are watching this video, or if anybody from them is watching this video, comment below and let me know whether you guys are the ones that shot the video or you just got your hands on it and you're just promoting your podcast. I don't really know, but I like to give credit where credit is due. So please, at the very least, comment below. So let's look at that now. Let me just bring up the old screen. Okay, here we go. Alrighty. Okay, so let's take a look at this together. I'm going to hit play here. And here we are. So in the center of your screen here, you have Lonnie Elam running into frame with that little orange pumpkin bucket of candy that we talked about in my live stream from a couple of days ago that was clearly in there. And then he moves off to his left and runs out of frame. And then right over here, this little white thing, that's Michael Myers' mask. He's walking into frame. He's behind the pillar now. He'll walk over here. He'll probably get some direction from probably the AD that yells, you know, stop, hold, or something to that effect. There you go. You hear the cue from off camera. Michael stops, turns to his right, looks, and starts walking in the direction of Lonnie Elam. Very interesting. Is that Nick Castle? I don't know. It's not James Jude Courtney, that's for sure. At least I don't believe so. Let's watch this again closer. Let's zoom up here and watch this again. Here we go. Okay, right the center of your screen here, there's little Lonnie Elam with his bucket of Halloween candy and the pumpkin, looking around. Does he see Michael? Does he see the shape? Is that the moment he sees the shape and takes off running? It could be. He runs out of frame. There's Michael right there, waiting for his cue, starts walking. He's hidden behind this big pillar here. I feel like I'm giving play-by-play in some sports. And then he enters frame, and there he is, gets some direction from one of the crew members, probably the AD, who knows, turns to his right and starts walking in the direction of Lonnie Elam and then walks out of frame. So interesting stuff indeed. Let's watch it one more time. So this is my thought, is that it's entirely possible that this is a chase scene, 100%. But what is the context here? The only time I can think that Michael Myers would even run into Lonnie Elam from the original Halloween would be after he shot six times and falls off the balcony. Maybe this is after that. Maybe this is Michael coming from the backyard and he sees Lonnie Elam and he recognizes him from earlier in the day when he saw him picking on Tommy Doyle. And he's like, oh, I know that kid, you know, but this seems a little robotic. He seems to sort of come right up, then turn, then go after Lonnie Elam. You'd think if he was chasing Lonnie Elam, he just would have gone from over here right in Lonnie Elam's direction. And that brings me to my other thought, which is this. This is my thought. We don't know where the camera is set up, and we don't know where these characters, where Lonnie and where the shape are entering frame. Where are their marks? Just because Michael is coming from way back here doesn't mean that that's where the camera is getting him from, right? It could be. I mean, we do know that he does come out of the darkness, right? But it's entirely possible that his mark and where he enters frame is closer to the road. They're just having him start from back here to get that lead in. In voiceover, there's something called a lead in line, and it's something that I might say at the beginning of reading a movie trailer or a commercial or a promo or something to that degree to get myself into character. So let's say the line begins with, you know, it's a commercial and it begins with, it's a promo, let's say, and it begins with, you know, next on NBC, right? Or coming up on Fox, right? Well, instead of beginning right with that line, I might say something like, hey man, what's going on? Yeah, I totally know what you mean. And then read, coming up on Fox. It's that lead-in line that helps me get into character, but in post, they remove that, obviously. They don't include that in the actual promo or the commercial. So the same thing could be happening here. They start him back further to get that lead-in, to get Michael into character, to get some distance between him and his mark, so they get the walk ride, and he gets into character, and by the time he gets to the roadside, he knows he's entering frame, he knows he's getting to his mark, and that's when he actually enters frame. That's entirely possible. So, and with Lonnie, the same thing. Lonnie, we see him come into frame and he stops and he looks around, but just because he's coming from way over here somewhere doesn't mean that they're capturing him from that far away, entering frame. There's a whole bunch of variables that we don't know in terms of where their marks are, where the camera is, where the frame is, how are they utilizing whatever they're shooting there, and how are they going to utilize that in post-production. What we do know, certainly at the very least, is that Lonnie Elam and Michael Myers have some sort of run-in. To what degree is the question? Just looking at that video, I think to myself, we'll watch it one more time here. Just looking at that video, I think to myself that maybe, you know, there's some sort of, that maybe this is after he shot six times and he falls off the balcony. But why is Lonnie alone? Did Lonnie go trick-or-treating after he got his ass away from there, but his buddies didn't want to go, you know, and he went by himself? Did he have a run-in, you know, a falling out with his buddies, and that's why he's alone? Or did they somehow get disconnected and separated, and that's why he's alone, and Michael sees him, and he's like, I know that fucking kid, right? But Michael seems pretty composed to have just been shot six times. I get the sense that maybe this is happening earlier in the night, but then that leads me to believe if it is, at what point is it happening? Because, you know, I think to myself, we pretty much know where Michael is at all times when it's nighttime in the original Halloween. I mean, he's following Laurie and Annie in his car, and it just cuts from, you know, late evening to night. And he gets out of the car, walks across the street, hides behind that tree in front of the Wallace house. So we know from that moment forward pretty much where he is at all times at night. He's across the street at the Wallace house. So where at this point does this take place? My first thought is after he's been shot six times, and this is him sort of, you know, coming out from the bushes from behind the backyard, and he sees Lonnie, that kid that he saw earlier. Maybe that's what's going on there. But to be honest with you, maybe it is prior to him being shot. Because during my episode of Thorazine this morning, which is a Level 3 Patreon-only show that I do every second Saturday, it's a Halloween-only live AMA, I was talking to a patron of mine, Darren Sands, great supporter of the channel. Darren, how you doing? And we were hammering home some ideas of what we were seeing here, because I showed it on my show there. And then we started to think, you know, maybe it is prior to him being shot. Although there is circumstantial evidence to suggest that it could be afterwards, for example, he's not carrying a knife, and you could make the argument that, well, he would have left the knife in the master bedroom, presumably the master bedroom, I think that's what it was, of the Doyle house, because Laurie stabs him in the abdomen and tosses the knife aside, and Myers never picks it up again, and he's shot six times and falls off the balcony, so that's where the knife would have been left, and maybe that's why he doesn't have it in his hands here. However, However, it doesn't look like he's under any sort of distress in terms of being shot six times. We don't see any bullet holes. He's moving with relative ease. And that, again, that doesn't mean that it is prior. They could certainly add that in post. And the video is of really poor quality. So maybe there's some details that we are missing on the jumpsuit. I mean, that is absolutely 100% possible. But as I was talking to Darren, I thought to myself, you know, there is an example of my... I'm going full on fucking nerd here. This is hilarious. And you guys love it. You love it. There is an example of Myers leaving the premises of the Wallace house before killing Annie. And that is when Annie takes Lindsay across the street to the Doyle house. So Lori can watch her as well, because Annie is going to go and pick up Paul. And as they cross the street, they pass by Loomis's car, which is still there because that's where Myers parked it. And on the other side of the car, out of the blue, Michael Myers stands up completely out of the peripheral vision of Annie and Lindsay, just barely. And you hear that noise, right? Right? You know what I mean? And he's at the car. Well, why is he at the car? Why did he go back to the car? He was on, you know, the premises. He was on the property. He was watching Annie through the windows of the laundry room. He was watching Annie through the windows of the kitchen. He killed Lester the dog. What would cause him to go back to the car just so he could do that? Stand up on the other side of the car? That doesn't make any sense, right? I mean, obviously, you know, this is supposed to be a one-off film. Obviously, that is what it was. But, you know, in terms of the continuity they're building here, why would he go back to the car? Well, maybe... because we don't see him carrying a knife the first time he exits the car and watches Lindsay's parents leave and Annie enter the house, we don't see a knife on him. Maybe he left the knife in the car. Because remember, what does Brackett say? You know, somebody picked up a Halloween mask, a rope, and a couple of knives, right? So maybe he left them in the car. So he went back to the car to get the knife, right? To kill Annie when she returns to the house. Maybe that's what's going on there. And then he suddenly sees them crossing the street and he's like, oh shit. And he ducks behind the car. Full on fucking nerd here. So all I'm saying is that there is evidence of Myers leaving the premises for a brief time for whatever reason, even though it's on the same street. Who's to say that he didn't do that on the other street over for some reason? I don't know. But other than that, when you watch the original Halloween, it's very apparent that Michael, you know, he's pretty much locked in there at that location. So where he meets Lonnie, I don't know, unless they're just going to say they're going to build continuity and just say, no, when Lori was telling Tommy that there's no such thing to, you know, about the boogeyman, this is when Michael has this run-in with Lonnie. But then, of course, where's Lonnie's friends, right? Is this before the get your ass away from there? Or is it prior? Or sorry, afterwards, I should say. It could go either way. If I was a betting man, I would probably say, I think this is prior. I think this is prior. Where that fits in relation to the continuity of Michael presumably being at the Wallace house the entire time, I don't know. But we do know he does go back to the car. I don't think he went, I'm thinking about this, wait. We're left to assume that he went back to the car to get the knife and get the rope, and that's when he saw Annie and Lindsay coming out of the house, so he ducked behind the car, and when he, you know, when they walked by the car, he stood up and then he took his knife and his rope as they went into the Doyle house and sneaked back into the garage and hid in the car to kill Annie because he overheard that she was going to go get Paul. Do you think there's a full-on chase scene happening here? Or do you think that maybe, like I do, that this kind of looks like maybe the beginning of Michael Myers being a little curious about who Lonnie is? Or maybe he, you know, oh, I remember that kid. I'm going to go check this kid out or something. It kind of looks like that. But again, the way they shoot films and knowing marks and when an actor you know, comes into frame, and it's really difficult to sort of get a full rounded idea of what really is going on there and how they're going to use those two different cuts and those two different shots. But it's interesting to talk about. Comment below and let me know your thoughts. Hey, if you want to follow me on Facebook, you can at facebook.com/manythingsDaveMcRae. That's where I tend to post in the meantime and in between time, and I'm not posting here. All my links are in the description, as well as links to my Patreon, my merch store, my IMDb, my Twitter, my official websites. They're all down there. Check them out until your heart's content. Oh, hey, that might be my agent. I gotta go. Okay, I'll talk to you guys soon. Cheers.